This video has been made possible by our sponsor, Squarespace. Whether you need a domain, website, or online store, check it out for a free trial. And when you are ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/creatnprocess to save 10% off your first purchase. Make your next move with Squarespace. Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. In today's tutorial, we are going to create a graphic design combining both image and vectors. We are going to create this design using Illustrator and Photoshop software. So let's start with our design. This is the image edited by me using the Photoshop. Now we'll see how to edit the normal image according to our design. Firstly, go to the file menu, click on new, take a new document with a particular width and height. After that, drag the downloaded image into your document. And now, pick the magic wand tool and select the background area. Then select the lasso tool and select this signature region. After that, click on mask. And this will remove the background region. Now, select the hue and saturation adjustment layer and decrease the saturation level so that the image will turn into black and white. And now, select the brightness and contrast adjustment layer, then click on legacy and adjust the contrast and the brightness of the image. Then go to hue and saturation adjustment layer again and adjust the color values to give a brownish tint. And now, check the overall look of the image and make some adjustments. After that, go to filter, pixelate and select fragments. Then adjust the opacity level and click OK. Now, here we can see some unwanted parts in the image. To remove that, double click on the layer and click on mask edge. In that panel, adjust the radius level, then shift edge and smooth the levels. So we got a nice smooth border of the image. Then click on OK. Now our image is ready for our design. Let's go to Illustrator now. So this is the one we are going to design like this with the image. And now, firstly, pick the rectangle tool and create a box. After that, pick the pen tool and add 2 points at the top and 2 points at the bottom. Then pick the die selection tool and select the top 2 points. Move it a bit inside. And now, select the bottom 2 points and move it inside. After that, pick the anchor point tool and drag the bottom part points to give a smooth curve. And then move the bottom end point slightly inside. Now, using the die selection tool, drag the anchor point slightly for a smooth shape. Then repeat the same process for the bottom. After that, select the rectangle tool and create a box up to half of the shape. Then select both shapes and click on minus front. Now pick the scissor tool and click on both top and bottom points to cut the stroke line. Then delete the line and now switch the fill color to stroke and adjust the color. After that, go to Effect, 3D and click on Revolve. In this panel, click on Preview and make X, Y and Z values 0. Then go to Surface and select No Shading and click OK. Now select the shape and go to Object and click on Expand Appearance. Again go to Object and click on Expand Appearance. After that, select the shape and right click and click on Ungroup. Then select the bottom part and ungroup it until it gets separated. And now click on Unite and repeat the same for the top part as well. Then select the shape, keep it aside and delete the unwanted shapes. After that, select a middle shape and apply gradient color. Here, delete the darker slider and add a slider at the middle. Keep it gray color. Then make one more copy. In that, reduce the darkness and add one more slider. Then edit the sliders and the colors to get a nice gradient on the shape. And now select the upper part. Then pick some color with the eyedropper tool and edit the sliders by changing the places to show the reflection variation from bottom part. Then give some angular rotation to the gradient. After that, select the top part and decrease the length. Take a copy and place it on that. Now select that and apply gradient. Then edit the gradient slider by matching it to the bottom shape. And now select the top part and apply gradient to it. Here in the gradient panel, change some color and add some slider in the middle and edit the shape of gradient. Now select the bottom part and apply gradient and change it into radial type. After that, pick the gradient option and compress the radial shape. Then select the shading area and change the black color into gray. Now select the shape and go to Effect, Stylize and click on Inner Glow. Then click on Preview, change the color and edit the opacity and the blur values. After this, go to Photoshop and select the layer. Then right click and click on Merge Visible. Now just drag and drop the image from Photoshop to Illustrator. Then increase the size and place it on the artboard. After that, pick the ellipse tool, draw a circle on the eye and take a copy of that. Now take the pan tool and draw a shape like the specs. Then select these three shapes and press Unite option on the Pathfinder. And now select the pen tool and add a point in the middle of the shape. Then using the anchor point tool, edit the points to give a smooth shape. After that, pick the die selection tool and edit the shapes by dragging the anchor points. Here, after editing the shapes, we must create the glass region of the spectacles. So make a copy of the shape and scale down the size slightly. Now take the knife tool and give a cut in the middle of that copy. After that, delete the unwanted anchor points with the help of delete anchor point tool and edit the shapes with the help of handles. Then make a copy of the shape and click on mirror and place it according to the shape. And now pick the rectangle tool and create a line. Then make a copy of it with the alt pressed. After that, press Command or Control D to create multiple number of copies of the shape at equal distance or equal gap. And now select all the line shapes and click on Unite option on the Pathfinder. Then selecting the lines and the inside shape, click on minus front option. So we'll get a line shapes subtracted from the yellow shape. Then pick the die selection tool and edit the endpoints to give a smooth curves. After that, select the ellipse tool and create a circle at the right side of the spec shape. And take a copy to the left side. Then select the two circles, make them unite. then send it to back. Now increase the size and adjust it according to the eyes placement of the image. Then go to rectangle tool and create a box. After that, pick the pen tool and add 2 points in the middle top and the middle bottom of the box. And now select the 2 points and move it slightly down. After that, the bottom points too. Then select the anchor points tool to adjust the 2 points to give a smooth curve. Now to get these zigzag shapes, pick the knife tool and cut the shapes manually. Then delete that shapes. After that, select the text tool by pressing the T and type some text. Then match the font style by increasing the text size and decrease the gap between the letters. After giving a proper font to the text, place that on the box shape and make a copy. Now change the text of the bottom one with some font style, then increase the size according to the box. After that, select the direct selection tool and select the left and the right bottom points of the box and move it upwards slightly. And now take a copy of the bottom text and go to object and click on expand. Then click OK. Then click on unite and pick some stroke color. After that, click on stroke and change the align stroke in panel. And now set some stroke size and select the shape. Now right click and click on ungroup. Then select the separated texts and delete that part. And then edit the shapes on the text. After that, select the stroke shape and a box and click on unite option. Then send it to back. And now select both the text parts, then go to object and click on expand. Then click OK. After that, click on unite. Now select both the text and the box shape and click on minus front option. Next, take a copy of the shape and adjust it slightly downward. And now take a rectangle tool and create a box on the shape. Then select the pen tool and add some points at the top and the bottom. Next, pick your die selection tool and adjust the shapes according to the text part. Here, I'll add one more point with the pen tool and move it a bit side. Then send it to back. After that, select the front shape and apply gradient. In that palette, change the color to orange and yellow. Then gradient type to linear. And now delete the two right sliders and drag the left sliders to middle. In this middle slider, select some brighter color. And in the right slider, select the darker orange. Here, add one more slider to merge the darker color into brighter to get a 3D feel with the gradients. Next, select the spectacle shapes, then right click and click on ungroup. After that, select the background shape and apply the same below gradient color with the eyedropper tool. Then, delete one slider in the middle and edit the color gradient. Next, select the inner shapes and set a color matching to it. Here, select the background shape and edit the dark colors in the left and the right slider. And change the middle slider color matching with the shapes. And now we'll add a tree shape on our design. So for that, select the shape and keep aside. Then place the canned design on the artboard. Here I have downloaded some tree shapes. So let's drag and drop into our artboard. Next, scale down their size and ungroup them. Now keep the separated trees side by side by attaching one on one. Then select all and click on unite option. Next, place the tree shapes on the canned design and make a copy to the bottom. Then select the bottom shape and decrease the opacity levels. Next,
We'll create a duplicate of the can shape using the shortcut Command Ctrl C to copy and Command Ctrl F to paste in front. Then right click and arrange it to front. And now select the tree shapes and the can shape and apply Make Clipping Mask. After that, select the tree shapes and decrease the opacity level. Here, change the blending mode to multiply and set the opacity. Then select the can and drag and drop into a new Photoshop document. Next, scale up the size and drag and drop the image into a document. After that, select the other shapes from the Illustrator and drag and drop into the Photoshop document. Also, I'd like to thank Squarespace for supporting the channel. It's an all-in-one platform where you can go and create a beautiful website. They have got this really easy to use platform. They have got designer's template, domains, and really good customer service 24/7. You can easily open online stores that allow you to manage your products, orders, and inventory easily. If you want to try it out, go to squarespace.com/creatnprocess to save 10% off your first purchase. Highly recommended. Make your business stand out with Squarespace. Thanks for listening, guys. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. See you in the next episode.